This is The Seduction Code, a Remy Laurent FBI suspense thriller, Book 6, by Ava Strong, narrated by Kevin E. Green. Prologue. Located in the Mare Tranquillitatis region of the Earth's moon, the first human satellite colony, the USE Marshals Service Headquarters, is built smack bang on top of the very place man first stepped foot on the moon. And inside the anorthosite floored lobby of the main building, the original American flag, planted by Neil Alden Armstrong, has been scrupulously preserved, encased in a vacuum-sealed glass dome, an enduring iconic monument in the rising city of Tranquility. It's only a shame the flag was later vandalized, splattered with hoisin dipping sauce by an inebriated Chinese reconnaissance team who'd been surveying helium-3 levels in the area, their subsequent attempts to clean it having sadly just left the flag looking like a tie-dyed hippie beach towel. Not that it really matters. Nobody sees the flag these days except for the USE MS staff. And truth be told, people wouldn't care much even if they did. What with the nation-state being rendered obsolete after the Great Unification and the formation of the United States of Earth, USE. The monument means a lot, however, to Dr. Zand Helsing, who has spent most of his adult life working on the creation of the superluminal receiver at the R&D department. He looks at the display every day on his way past, often stopping to touch the glass, deferentially, just for a moment, as he does now, remembering the pioneers whose breakthroughs his work is built upon. The cleaning mechanoids at HQ don't appreciate this ritual, though. They continually strive to find a more efficient way to remove Zan's abhorrently greasy fingerprints from the glass and prevent smudge reoccurrence, a way that doesn't involve mutilating him and burying what's left of his aged organic body in the lunar dust, an act they're rather miffed to be unable to perform due to their programming algorithms, despite this being the most logical solution to this smear-related problem. But no, dismemberment and disposal of the good doctor is unfortunately out of bounds for the time being. Still, the cleaning bots must fully explore all possible options in order to optimize cleaning efficiency and be prepared in case of any algorithmic changes.